Hello everyone and welcome back to my kitchen. Today I wanted to share with you one of my personal favorite dinner dishes, and I'll be making my pan-seared duck breast with a red wine, plum sauce, and mashed sweet potatoes. The combination of flavors and textures is simply incredible. The duck breast is super juicy, tender, and then combine it with the plum sauce and the potatoes and you are in food heaven. This impressive restaurant quality dish is typically really popular around the holiday season, but my husband and I just can't get enough of it. We eat it year round and I make it at least once or twice a month. I'm going to start by showing you how to score, season, and fry the duck breast so it's nice and tender, perfectly cooked, and then we'll pair it with that simple red wine plum sauce, serve it with my mashed sweet potatoes. So I have a separate video for the potatoes. I'll include the link down in the video description box below. You can also use regular potatoes. Even if you think you don't like duck or if you haven't liked it in the past, this dish is going to change your mind. It is so incredibly simple, easy, and delicious. For the full list of ingredients and the print to bone instructions, don't forget to head on down into that video description box and over to my website. I have everything online. Meanwhile, let's get started. Let's get started with the duck. This recipe is great for 2 to 4 pieces of duck breast meat. If you want more servings, just increase that plum sauce. I love to have lots of it, and I think it adds lots of great flavor. Now, I get my duck breast frozen from Whole Foods, so I thaw it out first, and then the night before, I take it out of the packaging, pat it dry, set it into a tray like this one, and then just place it back into the refrigerator uncovered for that moisture to evaporate. You want really dry skin on the duck, that way you're gonna have really nice crispy skin on the outside. You're going to have that nice caramelization. First, we need to score the duck breast skin, and for that we're going to need a really, really sharp knife. So sharpen your knives beforehand, and you want to cut little scores in the duck breast skin on the top, but make sure you're not cutting all the way through down to the meat. And this way the fat is going to cook evenly, it's going to render really nicely. And then turn the duck breast over to the other side and cut away any excess fat off the back. And at this point, I'm going to season it generously just with salt, sprinkling on both sides. Let's head over to the stovetop. I'm going to be using a stainless steel pan today, and you want to start with a cold pan. So set it over medium heat and then place the duck breast skin side down into the cold pan. Now, I know you usually want to start with a hot pan, but for duck breast specifically, starting with a cold pan will allow that duck fat to render nice and slow. And then just let the pan and the heat do their job. You don't need to touch the duck breast or flip it over. Just let it slowly fry for about 10 to 14 minutes on that skin side, allowing that fat to slowly render until that skin is nice and crispy and golden. And check out that nice and crispy skin on the top. I'm gonna go ahead and turn the duck breast over at this point. At this point, I'm going to add some whole cloves of garlic to the pan, some fresh thyme, and you want to be careful with this because it likes to splatter when you add it into the hot oil. Fresh rosemary. And I also like to turn the duck breast and kind of cook it on the side as well. And when my duck breast is nearing finish time, I'm gonna go ahead and flip it over back down onto the skin side so it stays nice and crispy. And use a digital thermometer to make sure you're not overcooking these. You want an internal temperature. These are just about done. So internal temperature about 130 to 135. With my duck breast resting and finishing up on the side, I'm going to go ahead and get started with the red wine plum sauce. So we'll need 1/2 cup of red wine, and I typically like to use a Cabernet or Zinfandel. Pour that into a medium-sized saucepan. Once the wine comes up to a simmer, let it reduce for 5 minutes. Once the wine is reduced, we can finish up our sauce. I'm going to add in half a cup of plum jam. Today I'm using homemade plum jam, but you can also order it on Amazon. About a tablespoon of balsamic vinegar. If your plum jam is a little on the sweet side, you can add more. And I love to add about a tablespoon to 2 tablespoons of duck fat directly from the pan. Adds so much incredible flavor to the sauce. Give this all a whisk and then continue to reduce this over medium heat for another 5 to 7 minutes until that sauce is nicely thickened. Once your duck is nicely rested, grab a sharp knife, cut through that crispy skin. I like to do nice thin slices. Check out this duck. It's super, super juicy on the inside. The perfect color on the inside. I like it. Just a medium doneness. Oh, this is gonna be so good. For plating, let's grab some of those mashed sweet potatoes. And add some of that delicious plum sauce on the side. And then with each serving, I like to grab a little bit of the duck breast, dip it into the sauce, grab a little bit of that sweet potato. And that's it for my duck breast recipe. I absolutely love this dish. It is so incredibly aromatic and it's really easy to put together. This is another a favorite of mine for when I have guests or company coming over for dinner. It's always a huge hit with everybody. Don't forget to head on down into that video description box for the recipe link. I'm gonna have all the ingredients on my website, including the recipe for my mashed sweet potatoes. I like to get these started just around the time, like right before I get my duck breast in the pan so that they're hot and ready to go along with the duck. All right, let's dig in. I actually love to have lots of this plum jam. I also wanted to make a note, if you don't have any plum, cherry, like sour cherry jam will also work really well. And then you can drizzle some extra duck fat from the pan. And then my husband loves to eat the pan-fried garlic as well. You don't want to let that garlic go to waste. I'm gonna grab a little bit of everything, some of the mashed potatoes, a piece of this duck breast. Oh, smells so good. I love the aroma, a little bit of thyme, the rosemary. I am in food heaven right now. This duck is so incredibly delicious. I love having that crispy rendered skin on the top and the inside is so incredibly tender and juicy and flavorful. And what I love about duck is you really don't need too many seasonings or flavorings. The meat itself is so incredibly delicious. And then add to that, that tart wine and plum sauce on the side, which is also incredible. You could just eat it by the spoonful. I love having the mash, the sweet mashed potatoes. Of course you can use regular, but I find that really complements the duck. You have a little sweetness from the potatoes, the tartness from the plum sauce, the juicy duck. I mean, you can't ask for anything better. Whether it's for the holidays, for a special occasion, or just as an everyday meal, this duck dish is bound to be an instant hit. I hope you guys have enjoyed my latest video. If you enjoyed this recipe, please give me a big thumbs up and a comment down below. I always love to hear from you, and I'll see you next time with a new recipe.